I want to do this. I want to say something about Gaur Govinda Maharaj, because a few days ago was the disappearance day of him, and one very inspiring story about how he lived his family life, because Gaur Govinda Maharaj, he was perfect Grihastha, always completely Krishna conscious. But one day he decided to go, no one knows, and he left, and no one knows where he left. And he was in one village, and his wife, he knows that he is in this village, and he came to search for him, and some devotees came in and told him, your wife is coming. Then he said, oh, Maya is coming. And when she heard this, she fainted. So
she fainted
when she heard, because she was attached to her husband, but he said, Maya is approaching, Maya is coming. So Gaur Govinda Maharaj shows this extreme detachment from material world. This is what we finally have to come to this platform. Of course, we cannot
imitate.
We cannot imitate, but we have to understand on which platform we can come to Krishna.
Yes. This is if you are able to give up such attachment, then you will become qualified that Krishna may choose you. And this is not very easy. Mahaprabhu has shown the same thing when he left for sannyas. You can imagine, his mother, it was so dear to him, and she was so dear to him also. What to say, Vishnu Priya, yes. When he left, mother just sitting there, and he just left. She not saying anything. And then after they meet, when he came back to Chandipur after sannyas, his mother came there. And she was cooking. She was allowed to cook for him. But Vishnu Priya was not allowed to come there. How much attachment Vishnu Priya
had? It's
not easy to understand this. But she did not hate him for this. He was very attached to him. The only thing she got was his shoes. And they made some Gauranga Murti. And she worshipped the rest of her life. She worshipped this Murti and the shoes of
Mahaprabhu.
Yes, in Navadvip, this temple is still there. And her austerity was exemplary. For every mantra she chanted, she took one rice corn. And in the end of the day, what she had chanted, this rice she was eating. How long could he survive? I don't want this to like this. This is shown through the whole history of our acharyas. Mamsidas Babaji, from the worldly, from the mundane point, you know, it was very cruel how he behaved. He got married. He did not want to get married, but they married him. When his wife became pregnant, this is not to imitate. Nobody should think like this. But I just say what extreme some movies. I think. Then she delivered the child, and just after, he went away and never came back. Amritas. You can see he's very cold, but he was a Nityasita. He was a cowherd boy according to the... Acharyas. Prabhupada, he visited him sometimes. He was very close to him. But he did not allow anyone else to go. Any of his disciples were not allowed to see him. Because he was smoking and he was, his behavior was very not like we understand how Vaishnava was acting. Very special. He was drinking coffee. Our Guru Maharaj, he told also, he also saw him sometimes. He came to him. He always invited him for coffee. What did he say? Coffee? Coffee? That was very special. Yes, deities. Radha? Gomitai? Gomitai, I think.
And Radha Krishna.
And he was living in a tent, you know. And then sometimes, or once, a cow was entering the tent, and did this one thrown down to the. Then he came back and saw this. He was chastising the deities. You, Krishna, can you not look for you? I always have to care for you. When they were bathing in the Ganges, he also took the deities with him. He make a rope around the deities and he throw it in the Ganges. And back. He was playing like this. Sometimes in the middle of the night he thought, now I must cook for. They are hungry. And he was cooking big feast. And was offering. After 3-4 days he came back to consciousness again. And he realized, oh, the offering is still on it. I have to finish the offering. He was beyond this material world. Beyond time.